Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. Simplify square root of 21 minus 4 times square root of 5 plus 8 times square root of 3 minus 4 times square root of 15. In this video, we will introduce a special method to solve this question. Pay attention to the inside part of the square root. We have 1, 2, 3 square roots. Here, we are assuming the inside part of the square root equals square root of x plus square root of y minus square root of z, then square. If here we have a square, the outside, the square root sign will be canceled with this square. Here, x, y, and z are positive integers. Why? Here, we only have one negative sign. If we expand the right-hand side, we will have two negative square roots. Here, we also have two negative square roots inside of this square root sign. Simplify the right-hand side, we have this. We compare both sides, x plus y plus z is the constants without square roots. 2 square root of y, z equals 4 square root of 5. 2 square root of xy equals 8 square root of 3. 2 square root of zx equals 4 square root of 15. In summary, x plus y plus z equals 21. Here we have 2 square root of yz. Here is 4. 4 equals 2 times 2. We put another 2 inside of this square root. That's 2 square times 5. Similarly here, 8 equals 2 times 4. We need to put 4 inside of this square root. Should be 4 squared times 3. This 4 is 2 times 2. Put 2 back inside of this square root. It is 2 squared times 15. Continue to simplify. We have this result. What are we doing here? We want to find x, y, z. From the first result, we have x plus y plus z equals 21. Can we rewrite y in terms of x? Can we rewrite z in terms of x? Then we can solve this equation for x. Then y, then z. Y times z equals 20. X times y equals 48. This equation divided by this equation we have. Z equals 5 over 12 times x. From here, you can see that we can cancel y. This means we rewrite z in terms of x. Similarly, we can use the first equation, yz equals 20, divided by zx equals 60. Here is zx. From this equation, we have y equals 1/3 x. Now, we are ready to replace y and z in terms of x. Simplify, we have the answer for x. X equals 12. What is y? Replace x by 12. What is z? Replace x here by 12. We have x equals 12, y equals 4, z equals 5. We can replace x, y, z by these three values back into this right-hand side. Here, that's a square and a square root. We can cancel each other because the first two terms, add them together, is bigger than square root 5. Therefore, this number is positive. This is the final answer. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.